Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dolls. In this video, as the title says, I will show you how to make a Nintendo Switch for custom dolls. This will be part of a video section that I call myself as Crafts with the Hatter, where I'll be doing bow objects such as accessories of a smaller scale or anything else that you would like to see in a next video. Before I start, don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell so you can receive notifications. For the materials, we need pieces and wooden rods of those that they use to make models, sharp tools like a sapto knife and a scalpel, soft sandpaper, any strong glue. In my case, I will use this one that is of precision, 3D paint, and of course brushes and acrylic paint. And without more thing to say, let's get started. To have a better guide, I measure the Joy-Con with my hand, and with a wooden rod I take the hand of a doll and mark the height of the Joy-Con. And then cut it. I use the cut piece to mark on another rod on the same width. Then I frame with a ruler of the wooden sheet the length and width of the console, to be precise, a niche for the screen. Then I mark the Joy-Cons. With the help of a ruler, I begin to cut the shape using the scalpel. Now I start sticking the Joy-Cons on the wood. And other pieces around the screen. As you can see, the form is ready, and I just left a free space for something I will explain later. Then I will sand it so that the teeth have a more rounded shape. And here we have the console ready. With the scalpel, I give extra touches for a little more similarity. With a pencil, I draw the buttons of the Joy-Cons. And now, with 3D paint, I rise the buttons and wait for it dry. The console is ready with his buttons, now it's time to paint it. First, I start painting the screen with black paint. It is always better to fill everything and not leave spaces unpainted. And then I paint the Joy-Cons with the color that the console wears, although they can also be painted with any combination. My personal favorite is the neon yellow. And we continue painting the buttons. And here it is! For more painting work, I will draw the console logo on the back with white paint. Well, that looks awful. Next! Much better. And we have the little Nintendo Switch. To give the illusion of lit screen, I cut these pieces of paper of the specific size. And I paint and decorate with markers. The only thing to do is put the paper into the free space I left before. Oh, and you can also draw the logos on your favorite games from the console. We all say that it's ready. thank you so much for watching. My name is Eric and we'll see you next time. Bye!